Show.
Thank you.
That's good to see you. What a crowd you are.
Wow. We got a lot of great big fat monkey hits for you and some really cool surprises as well. I am one of the monkeys. And they said, yeah, thank you, no thank you. Don't call us, we'll call you. So Nez basically said, screw you. And he gave the song to a relatively unknown young girl singer who was kicking around Los Angeles at the time. Her name was Linda Ronstadt. This is Different Drama. Oh, in the early days again. We used to sit around the kind of proverbial campfire when we first met each other, and we would sing and play and goof around, and we would invariably sing Nez tunes because he was the only one writing tunes at the time. And so some of these very early songs are very, very special to me, like this one, Sunny Girlfriend.
Started after you think that she is there.
eventually all did start writing songs. I wrote a couple of cool tunes, encouraged by Nez. He said, you should start writing some songs. And I said, why? He said, because that's where the money is. I wrote a couple of tunes. David wrote a couple of great tunes. So did Peter. In fact, Peter wrote this next one. Peter, you listening? Became the theme song for the second season of the show called For Pete's Sake. Ago, back in the day, we had the pleasure of going over to the old country, to England, where we met the members of the royal family.
Terry, Tommy, Billy, Tubby, and Money. It was Money was the last one, right? No. What happened?
No, the other royal family.
Oh, much more Money. Oh.
The Beatles, that royal family. We met the Beatles, and one night, they threw us a party.
No, hang on. They threw us out of a party. Think back. Can you remember that far back?
No.
Think back, okay.
No.
Well then, they threw us out of a party. Oh. I sailed right beside you as we went over that upriver.
Did I have a good time?
Oh, you had such a good time.
Okay. Well, that makes up for it. So I left. I guess I got thrown out of the party, and I went back to my hotel, and on Nez's encouragement, I wrote a song called Randy Scouse Git. Okay. I didn't know what it meant, that term. I'd seen it on television, but it sounded cool. Months later, I find out that it translates as horny Liverpudlian putts. She's a wonderful lady and she's mine all. And there doesn't seem a way she won't come and lose my time. Two easy humming songs to a girl in a yellow dress. Been a long time since the party and the room is in a mess. The four kings of Vienna. stay on the floor. There are birds out on the sidewalk, a valet at the door. It reminds me of a penguin with few and plastered hair. There's tap of powder on the letter, and the birthday boy is there. Number one place by that stinking group, the Beatles. About 3 or 4 years ago, Nez, Peter, and I, to do a first new Monkey album, and in a long, long time. And they're called Good Times. And produced by the incredible late, great Mr. Adam Schlesinger. You know, at the beginning of the Monkey Experience, when we first got together, of course, Nez was writing great tunes. But we also had this amazing stable of songwriters who were writing songs for us at the time. People like Tommy Boyce and Bobby Hart. Incredible. Carol King and Jerry Garfield. Harry Nilsson. Paul Williams. David Gates. I mean, Barry Madison. Wow. Neil Diamond. Neil Sedaka. Neil Armstrong. And so when we started this new album, all of a sudden, all these great, young, hip, new, cool songwriters came out of the woodwork and said, boy, we'd like to write some songs for you guys. We have some great songs on that album, one by Ben Gibbard from Death Cab for Cutie. And this next one, one of my favorite, written by Paul Weller from The Jam and Noel Gallagher from Oasis. many years ago. Called Head. Oh, you're the one that saw it. No, it was a pretty cool movie written by our good friend at the time, Jack Nicholson. And it was weird. kind of a cult movie now, I think it's become. But within that movie, there were some really wonderful, wonderful tunes. A couple of great tunes written by Nez. Great tunes, a couple by Peter Troy. And this next one, one of my favorite, written by Carole King and Tony Stern. As We Go Along. Who's gone now when I'm
Michael Nesmith.
Opportunities to write to these songs for the monkeys, knowing where they would ultimately go and how they would ultimately incorporate themselves into young lives. And I thought about myself as an 8-year-old or a 4-year-old, sitting alone in my basement in that horrible carpet that they put down. Where in the world did they get that? And I would sit down there and I'd put the records on and I'd listen to them. And these were just demos. They didn't have lyric, they didn't have anything to them at all at the time. And I thought, this is a place you can find reality, something that's real, something that I can touch, and that everybody who's like me and is also 8, who can touch it. You wonder, are these feelings I'm having, are they real? Can I be this sad? Can I be this lost? And I mentioned it to one of the producers over at the studio, and he said, "Mike, monkeys, they don't cry. They're not gonna cry." And I thought, "Are you out of your mind? Of course we cry." I sat down there, I cried. I was so touched by that moment of what the songs were about. Became real. And maybe it was, you know, confusing on some level in the 8-year-old mind, the 8-year-old heart, but still in all, there it was. There in that lonely room. So there was a song that had been kind of knocking around called "While I Cry." And so I thought, I'm going to write some lyrics to this thing. I don't know whether it'll hold up, but I'm going to put it out there. Because anybody who's reaching for it will be able to find it. And people who aren't, they won't care. And we give the young mind and the young idea seeker something to hold on to. Yeah. This is real. Don't let it slip away. There's something here. They told me what you'd do if I ever stayed with you. They told me that you laugh while I cry. They told me what you'd say, that you'd turn and walk away and find another place to play. While I cry, now I think back on those times. I didn't read between the lines how all the things that you said never seemed to match the things you did. Came true. song I wrote for Mick and us to sing together. Here you go. No heartaches felt, no longer lonely. Nights of waiting, finally lonely. Happiness that's all rolled up in you. Now with you as inspiration, I look toward a destination. Sunny, bright, than once before we blew. I have no more than I did before. If you know it, sing it. Now I've got all that I need. Yeah. For I love you and I know you love me. Yeah. So take my hand, I'll start my journey. Free from all the helpless worry. That be sense a man when he alone. What strength is mine when we're together? And with you I know I'll never have to pass the high road for the Lord.
Project, we didn't have a whole lot to say about what was going on. We were cast into the show, and they gave us scripts, and they gave us songs, and they gave us costumes, and they gave it. And so we didn't really have a lot to do with anything. But eventually, especially in terms of the music, we kind of drew a little line in the sand. Nez sort of drew the line.
They gave us a monkey mobile.
That's true. That's true.
They didn't give it to us, but we drove it around without permission. So, you know, just like you do with your parents' car. Oh, no, I didn't take it.
Yeah. But eventually, we did get some power from the powers that be.
Boom.
And they gave us permission to go into the studio and record a song all by ourselves. Just the four of us. This is it, the first one we ever did, The Girl I Knew Somewhere.
Yeah.
You tell me that you've never been this way before. You tell me things I know that I've heard somewhere. You're standing in the places, staring down through faces, bringing to mind traces of a girl. Yeah.
You want to do Tapioca Tundra?
We better. It's the next one on the set list.
This is our set list. I gotta run. We were coming off the stage at the first concert we ever played, which was in, where was it? It was in Hollywood. Wasn't it in Hollywood?
Hawaii.
Was it in Hollywood?
Hawaii. Honolulu.
Oh, Hawaii, yeah. Hawaii. So we were coming off the stage in Hawaii, and when we were walking off, and this like 15, 20,000 people were there. It was huge and for us. And I turned to Mick as we were walking up. And I said, Mick, for some reason when we were up there, I know it was just the four of us, but didn't it seem like there was somebody else up there with us? And Mick said, yeah, those were the monkeys. A wise man. And I realized, everybody's in on this thing. We know how it goes. We sing it for you and you sing it back to us. What a thing, huh? Yeah. So I wrote this song, Tapioca Tundra, which basically, I thought, close the loop. Reason verse, some prose or rhyme, lose themselves in other time, and waiting hopes cast silent spells that speak in clouded clues. It cannot be just part of me, for now it's part of you. Yeah. Thank you.
should have taken off my shoes. It's front page of news. Seniors are getting old, hungry, sleepy, wet and cold. Don't you forget it, nice. Should have taken her advice. I wanna go on home, glad to leave that girl alone. What way to spend the night if I don't drown or die of fright? Pep taught me how to float, can't swim a single note. Do me and teach me how I think and float like I'm on a cow. Now floated without screaming all the one of the finest bands I have ever played with. Unfortunately, they missed the flight, but these guys and girls are pretty good too, don't you think? Over here on Vocal Direction, keyboards and background vocals, please give it up for Mr. Alex Jules. Up here on the Big Bad Bass, Mr. Big Bad John Billings. Our new kid in town on guitars and vocals, please say hello to Amin Zarukian. Up here, my good little buddy from that little state of Connecticut. Great little drummer, taught him everything he knows. Show him that fill that I taught you.
Hey, Mickey, give him a
Let's
hand.
Let's give him a hand. Mr. Rich Dark, give it up. Over here on this wonderful steel guitar, please say hello to Mr. Pete Finney. And over here, our musical director for many, many decades. You're too long. And background vocals and every guitar in the book. Please give it up for Mr. Wayne Avers. And up here on percussions and background vocals, and the spirit of our little company, please say hello to my dearly beloved sister, Coco Dolans. Guys, getting light, everything will be all right. Think I finally got the knack. Only lazy on my back, never really like that town. Think I'll grab the rip and that just looks slow and felt free. Ripple singing on me. Way back in the sunshine.
Lane
the drum a little bit louder. Tell me I can live without her if I only listen to the band. Listen to the band!
Yes, I have.